gentlemen and fellow gamers out there, my name is Gamer LCD, and welcome back to the Gamers Rant. This is episode 17. I know it's actually been a while since I made an episode for the Gamers Rant, but I felt like today's discussion would be perfect to bring it back to life. Today's topic is kind of a sensitive area, but it's actually a topic that's very close and dear to my heart. Today we're going to be talking about massively multiplayer online RPGs. Now the reason why I say it's a very sensitive topic is because a lot of people have their own idea and their own opinion about what is a good game and what makes a bad game. A good example of this would be Bioshock Infinite. Mostly everyone out there said it was a near perfect game. 10 out of 10s, 5 out of 5s. But for example, let's say I played Bioshock Infinite and I thought it was just an amazing game. But my friend also played Bioshock Infinite and he said that it was a terrible game. Now, even though I have to disagree with him, I still have to respect his opinion because he might not like first-person shooters, and the list goes on and on and on. So when you guys are listening to this video, just keep those kinds of things in mind when you're listening, just to make sure that you respect everyone's opinions and that everyone has their own idea about what makes a good game. So, as you guys know, I usually try to keep these videos as short as I possibly can. I know I always say that and then I'm going way over my set time limit. But this time around, I'm not going to set a time limit and I'm just going to keep talking until I feel like I'm done talking. So, without further ado, let's actually get started. So the whole focal point surrounding this video is going to try to be to answer one simple question. Are MMORPGs becoming a dying breed of video game genre? Now, I know you guys will have your own opinions going into this video, but I want you to take into account everything that I discussed throughout this video and incorporate that into your answer in the comment section of this video below. So I want to start this video by discussing MMOs at its beginning. I want to talk about the history of MMOs, how they came to be, and why they became so popular. So in the late 80s, early 90s, video games were just starting to take off. They started to become popular, and video game developers were looking for a way to completely immerse a player into this video game virtual world. They wanted to make a player doubt themselves. Am I really sitting in a chair in my living room, you know, holding a controller, or am I really this character named Don in this video game virtual world? And I'm sure that we can all agree that video game developers really achieved their goal in today's world. We take a look at video games like Oblivion, Bioshock Infinite, typically take a look at games like World of Warcraft or EverQuest. These are very immersive worlds that just drag us into their game. So I'm sure we can all say that we accomplished this. But why have MMOs become so popular? What made them so appealing to the player base? This is for one major reason. It's because it was a brand new experience. You know, we all know what a first-person shooter was. We all knew what a puzzle game was. We all knew what an adventure game was. But we had never seen this new experience called a massively multiplayer online game. We had never seen the things that they had to offer, like, you know, playing with your friends from across the world. We had never seen that before. And it could only be done through your computer. We had never seen it been done through a console yet. So what happened was that, you know, I could actually play with my friend from Florida when I'm sitting in California without having to be right next to him. You know, I could traverse through this entire world and continue to do that without having to play a different game. You know, with any other game back then, you played through the storyline of the game and then you were done with it. You went to go trade it in back into your local video game store to get a new game. So we had never been able to continue playing that game, even though we had done everything we could already do. We could continue to play. We continued to experience with friends. We continued to, you know, kill things. We continued to advance our character, earn new spells, learn new abilities, you know, level up and do things like that. That's what really drove people crazy, was the ability to level up their character. Leveling up was a huge, huge deal in massively multiplayer online games at the beginning. So we take this brand new experience called an MMO. We compare it to other things in today's world, like a really awesome tablet or a gaming laptop. You know, if we showed a gaming laptop or a tablet to somebody 15 or 20 years ago, they would have went insane. They probably would have passed out from, you know, amazement. They had never seen something like this before. So, you know, for them, it would have been the most amazing thing in the entire world, and they probably would have wanted to share it with everybody. You know, we compare that to today's world where technology is everywhere, and we show someone a tablet or a laptop, they say, okay, cool, and they move on. Because, you know, technology is always advancing. It's always moving faster and faster and faster, and people can't keep up with it. They always want the next big thing. which doesn't really compare with, you know, the world of MMOs or the world of video games 10 or 15 years ago. So, you know, we look at MMOs today and we say, another MMO. Oh, it's another World of Warcraft killer. Oh, another MMO. It's another World of Warcraft killer. Oh, we see Star Wars The Old Republic. Oh, we see, you know, Rift. Oh, we see Guild Wars 2. World of Warcraft killer. World of Warcraft killer. Which is what leads me into my next segment. We see all these MMOs come out today, and we all expect them to be better and better and better and better, but in reality, they're getting worse and worse and worse. So, a lot of people don't like to acknowledge this, but Blizzard was actually a very successful company way before they invented World of Warcraft. They had already had their Diablo series, they already had the original StarCraft, and they even had their Warcraft RTS series. So, Blizzard was actually very popular and successful way before World of Warcraft. But the reason what made World of Warcraft so popular and so amazing game that we know as today is because they started from the bottom just like everybody else. They saw these other games like EverQuest, which was a very popular game, the very first game, popular MMO that made a name for itself. Then we had games like Lineage and Tibia and Ultima Online. Those were the very first iterations of an MMORPG. And so what World of Warcraft did was that they take a look at these other games and they said, this is an amazing new space that we should get into. So they took a look at those other games and said, let's take what people love about those games, that amazing experience, and transfer it into our game. We're going to keep out all the bad stuff, though. We'll keep the good stuff. And so because of that, World of Warcraft has become what we know as today as, you know, the most successful and still is the most successful juggernaut of massive multiplayer online role-playing games. And I wonder why that is. It's mostly because of the fact that Blizzard did it right. I don't know how they did it, but they did it well and they did it right. People like to say that World of Warcraft is dying or dead already, but you know, the fact remains that World of Warcraft is the only subscription-based game or MMORPG out there that still has a subscription and still well over 7 million subscribers. That's $100 million a month. That's $1.2 billion a year just from one game, not to mention all of their, you know, their service fees and special transactions and stuff like that. So then we take a brand new MMO out there. You know, we take all these other games out there that are trying to be better than World of Warcraft. They all want a piece of that action. They all want a piece of that money that Blizzard is getting. So we take a look at game like these brand new games that have come out over the past few years, like Rift, Star Wars The Old Republic. We take a look at Guild Wars 2. We take a look at Terra. We take a look at all these brand new MMOs that have all trying to do one thing. Kill World of Warcraft. They all want a piece of that action. But the fact of the reality is that it will never happen. That's because of one reason. World of Warcraft was first to the game. They were the first people to do what everyone else tried so hard to do, which was get everyone in one centralized location and get everyone playing one game. And that's what the problem is right now. World of Warcraft started in 2004, and they're coming up on their ninth year anniversary, and I believe that World of Warcraft will always be there to stay, because let's take SWTOR, for example. Everyone said that game was going to be the World of Warcraft killer, but they played it for, you know, maybe a month, two months tops, and they went back to World of Warcraft, because that was the game they loved, that was the game they knew. They were just getting more of the same with SWTOR. You know, go to quest from quest to quest, turn it in, get XP, and level up. They've already experienced all that in World of Warcraft. In World of Warcraft, I go from quest to quest to quest, get XP, and level up. Same thing with Guild Wars 2. It's more of the same. It's a reskinned World of Warcraft. All these different companies are trying to beat World of Warcraft by trying to become World of Warcraft. But the problem there is that we don't need another World of Warcraft. We already have World of Warcraft. That's where companies are failing when they keep trying to, you know, develop this next big MMO that's going to kill WoW. But the reality is that it's never going to happen because we already have World of Warcraft. In other words, what I'm trying to say here, that's why I think that MMO genre is dying. Because once World of Warcraft is gone, there's really nothing else that's going to take its place. Sure, you can go play another game, that's, you can play, go play another MMO, but it's never going to be at the same caliber as World of Warcraft because everyone has already experienced it. Like I talked about at the beginning of this video was the fact that the reason why MMOs became so amazing and became the next big thing to go do with your friends was because it was a brand new experience. It was the nostalgia aspect. Oh, this is amazing. I've never done this before. But now it's becoming old after year after year after year, and MMOs keep trying to come out and do the exact same thing. People are getting tired of it. That's why you see the loss in subscription numbers from World of Warcraft. As the game gets older and older and older, they keep dipping in subscriber numbers because people keep experiencing the exact same thing. We kill raid bosses, we PvP. We go for the next expansion, we kill raid bosses, we PvP. And the same thing goes for any other game. We take a look at Rift. We, you know, we quest, we level up to the end game, we kill raid bosses, we PvP. We go up to the next, MMO, such as SWTOR. We, you know, we quest, we level up, we hit max level, we go raid, or we go PvP. So it's the same thing from game to game to game. And that's why I think people are getting tired of it. It's basically the same game with maybe one or two mechanics thrown in with its own original storyline. So for SWTOR, it's based on the Star Wars universe, but it's the same MMO genre. We go to Rift, it's based on the Rift universe, but it's the same MMO genre. We go to Guild Wars 2, it's based on the Guild Wars 2 universe, but it's the same MMO genre. And we can't move away from the genre because then it wouldn't be an MMO anymore. You could try to do something else, but it wouldn't be an MMO anymore. That's where I'm trying to go with this video. And I hope you guys are starting to understand what I'm trying to convey to you guys. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I've done this take about maybe 20 or 30 times now, and this is the first time I've actually felt like I've explained it well enough. But I hope you guys get where I'm trying to go with this. Now, let's talk about these upcoming MMOs, such as the Elder Scrolls Online or EverQuest Next, which actually looks great, by the way, I'll say. But in order to actually beat World of Warcraft, you can't become the next World of Warcraft. You have to be different. You have to find out what World of Warcraft did and don't do the same thing. You have to be individual. You have to find out what people like. Sure, it may be still an MMO, but if you do something that's amazing, do something that people have never seen before, do something that's going to bring that nostalgia experience, make that, give it that wow factor. Oh, I've never done this before. And this is going to bring me into that new world that a lot of people have been so waiting for such a long time. I don't want another World of Warcraft. World of Warcraft is always going to be there for me to go play whenever I feel like it, because that's what a lot of people played back in the day. It's what my friends played. It's what I first played. So I know it's going always going to be there for me, and I know it's always going to be fun for me. But I don't want to go play SWTOR because that's already World of Warcraft. I don't want to go play Guild Wars 2 because that's already World of Warcraft. I don't want to go play Rift because that's already World of Warcraft. I don't need another World of Warcraft. I want an MMO that's going to set apart from World of Warcraft and do something different, so that way I get a brand new experience. I get the new storyline that I want that each game already brings, but I also get new gameplay mechanics. I also get new, you know, ways to complete in-game content. Raiding and PvP, those are always mainstays for MMOs, but what's something different that I can do that I don't always have to depend on? You know, raiding always gets stale from game to game to game. It's always something that you'll be able to do. You know, raid bosses bring new mechanics and things like that, but, you know, in reality, it's always the same thing over and over again. You could argue that PvP is different each time, but in reality, it's the same thing. You kill a person, you kill a person, you kill a person in different ways. So what's different that these other games can bring? And I think EverQuest Next is a good example of this, because if you guys watched the, you know, the live stream of this when they presented the game a couple of days ago, they showed some really cool new aspects of the franchise that I think you guys will be really interested in. I'm not going to talk about EverQuest Next in this video, but you guys get the idea. They really did some things that I'm really interested in seeing further when it's further developed. But you guys get the idea. I think I'm going to wrap up this video, guys. I think you guys are tired of me talking at this point, but I think it's time for you guys to answer that question now. Are MMORPGs a dying genre of video game? And keep in mind everything that I talked about, the fact that it's not a brand new experience anymore, the fact that World of Warcraft is still the juggernaut, even though they are losing. You know, one thing I do want to talk about real quick is the fact that a lot of people think that World of Warcraft should go free to play when every other single MMO has gone free to play. Now, the reason why those MMOs went free to play is because they're unsuccessful. They weren't doing well. They were just another World of Warcraft that people didn't want to waste their time with. Why should I go spend my time playing this other MMO that is exactly, essentially the same to what I've been playing for 7 or 8 or 9 years now, which is World of Warcraft? I don't want to play it another 8 or 9 years and do another MMO that's exactly like World of Warcraft. Otherwise, I could just go back to playing WoW, you know what I'm saying? So You know, the reason why World of Warcraft isn't going free to play, and Mike Morhaime, the president of Blizzard Entertainment, already confirmed this, is the fact they will never go free to play with WoW unless they are dipped so far below subscription numbers, like 1 million subscribers or something like that. Then they may go free to play. That's exactly what he said. Right now, World of Warcraft, at its peak, had over 12.2 million subscribers during Wrath of the Lich King. Right now, they're at 7 million, which is understandable because as the game gets older, people get tired of it and they just want to move on to something else. But 7 million subscribers, at 7 million subscribers, World of Warcraft is still the number one and only subscription-based MMO out there to date. Every other single MMO out there right now on the market that you can currently go buy today is free to play. SWTOR is free to play. Rift is free to play. Guild Wars 2 is free to play. Terra is free to play. Any other MMO you can think of, Aeon is free to play. All those games are free to play now when they all started out with subscription fees. You want to know why? Because they were all World of Warcraft clones. Nobody wants those games. And if I want to play a World of Warcraft clone, I'll go play World of Warcraft. So Blizzard is making over $100 million a month in subscription fees at 7 million subscribers. That's $1.2 billion a year just from World of Warcraft. So just keep that in mind, guys. World of Warcraft doesn't need to go free to play. It will continue to be the king as long as people are willing to pay for it. So as long as people are willing to pay for it, Blizzard will never go free to play with World of Warcraft. And they already said that Titan, their an upcoming MMO in 2016, will be free to play. So just keep that in mind too. So they're looking to the future. But like I said, I'm going to wrap up this video, guys. So I just want to know, I want you guys to answer that question, but I don't want you to quickly answer it. I want you to think about it for a little bit and take into account everything that I've talked about. The fact that World of Warcraft is always going to be there. The fact that every MMO who has tried to copy World of Warcraft failed because people don't want another World of Warcraft. And I know I've said World of Warcraft so many times in this video, but you guys get the idea. I'm actually going to do a really cool game. I'm actually going to put a counter in my video of how many times I said World of Warcraft. So that's going to wrap it up, guys. My name is Gamer LCD. I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope I didn't repeat myself too much, but you guys, I hope I tried to convey what I wanted to talk about here. Like I said, I had to actually do this take about 30 or 40 times, so it was kind of ridiculous. But anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Gamer LCD, and I'll see you next time.